Hi, let's talk about cardiac veins. So you may recall that the coronary arteries are going to supply the myocardium with blood. Well, it's the cardiac veins that drain the myocardium of blood. Now, very important to the cardiac veins is the coronary sinus. That coronary sinus is a dilation of the veins that rest in the posterior aspect of the coronary sulcus. And it's fed by three veins. There's the great cardiac vein that originates in the anterior interventricular sulcus. There's the middle cardiac vein that originates in the posterior interventricular sulcus. And then there's the small cardiac vein that runs along the inferior border of the heart, so it's accompanying the right marginal artery. And all three of these are going to feed into the coronary sinus that then feeds into the right atrium directly. In addition, there are also anterior cardiac veins. And these anterior cardiac veins are odd because they drain directly into the right atrium and bypass the coronary sinus, which we'll see. So here is an anterior view of the heart, which we were missing before. And here we can see the great cardiac vein ascending along with that anterior interventricular branch. That great cardiac vein is going to wrap around through the coronary sulcus and feed into the coronary sinus. Here we can see the small cardiac vein in association with that right marginal branch riding along the inferior margin of the heart and then finding the coronary sulcus and then feeding into the coronary sinus. But most importantly from this view, we can see the anterior cardiac veins. They're typically 3 to 5 anterior cardiac veins. They're draining the superficial aspect of the right ventricle, and they run obliquely across the heart like this, and they hop over the right coronary artery, and they feed then directly into the right atrium. So let's look at this cadaverically. So we can see the great cardiac vein coming around in that coronary sulcus to feed into the coronary sinus here. So there's the great coming around into the coronary sinus. Here we have the middle cardiac vein joining the coronary sinus there. And it's difficult to see the small, but if we were to take a right lateral view of the heart, we can see here's that right marginal branch there, and intertwined is going to be that small cardiac vein that meets up with the coronary sinus. Here and here, we can see two examples of anterior cardiac veins that are going to drain that right ventricle directly into the right atrium and therefore bypass the coronary sinus altogether. So we've discussed the distribution of the cardiac veins and the regions they drain. Thank you.